sharp day, when the heat of a rolling wave can't be turned away. An enchanted moment, and it sees me through. It's enough for this restless warrior just to be with you. And can you feel the love tonight? It is where we are. It's enough for this wide-eyed wanderer that we got this far.
Thank you. afternoon, everyone, and a very warm welcome to the Old Course Hotel and Paige and Ryan's special day, their wedding day. Each of you have been invited here because you are the most important people in Paige and Ryan's lives, and they are delighted to be sharing today with you all. Now, throughout the ages, weddings have been special events, bringing family and friends together to make memories, and today you all have the privilege of sharing in Paige and Ryan's wedding as they stand before us and share their love, promises and hopes for the future, and of course make their legal declarations as required under Scots law before they enter the next chapter of their lives as husband and wife. Now, I should probably introduce myself now. My name's Sheila Scobie and I'm a celebrant from the Humanist Society Scotland, and I was delighted to be asked to conduct today's wedding. Humanism aims to be guided by reason, with kindness, compassion and understanding of others, irrespective of our differences at its core. These characteristics are, of course, at the heart of a successful marriage. The fact that today is a non-religious marriage in no way implies any lack of respect for traditional values, and it certainly doesn't diminish the love and commitment that Paige and Ryan feel for each other. In fact, in making the choice to have a humanist wedding, Paige and Ryan have been able to play a huge part in putting today's ceremony together. And many of the words today are their words, and they have chosen readings for the ceremony, both by Scotland's national bard, Robbie Burns, and the first one, A Red, Red Rose, is going to be read by Dana.
My love is like a red, red rose that's newly sprung in June. My love is like a melody that's sweetly played in tune. It's fair are you, my bonny lass, so deep in love am I. And I will love you still, my dear, till all the seas gang dry. Till all the seas gang dry, my dear, and the rocks melt with the sun. And I will love you still, my dear, for the sands of life shall run. And fare you well, my only love, and fare you well a while. And I will come again, my love, though it be 10,000.
Now, we all have our own love stories. Some are short, others are long. Some are as yet to begin, while others are just getting to the good part. Some chapters are happy and exciting, while others might be sad and disappointing. But given that we're here today to see Paige and Ryan take the next step in their story, we thought it might be nice to tell you a wee bit about their story so far. Well, Paige and Ryan have known each other since childhood, but it was a while before their paths properly crossed. It was around Christmas 2016 that they reconnected and began dating while Paige was still at university in Dundee. Their first date was on a Friday night in Falkirk. Ryan ironed his shirt backstage at the panto he was working on. And Paige got changed in her car, having come straight from a dance class. Later that week, they went skating at the Edinburgh Christmas Market. When they got on the ring, Paige let it slip that she had done figure skating as a child. And that was much to Ryan's dismay. They recall it as being a lovely evening, holding hands and going round the ice. That is until Ryan slipped and fell, and Paige just let go. Because she didn't want her jacket to get wet. They have enjoyed lots of holidays together, booking their first holiday to Berlin just 3 months into their relationship. Both being Disney daft, they soon booked Florida for the first time that year, which has since become their favourite. This has become their go-to destination. But Ryan almost didn't make it home one year after breaking some Christmas baubles on the last day while they were packing to come back home. Luckily, they were easily replaceable, but not before Paige made sure that the shop assistant knew exactly who it was that was at fault. While they have shared interests, they also have individual interests too, creating a good balance. Paige loves all fitness activities, and Ryan leaves her to it. However, he did say the reason he leaves her to it is because it's for fear of showing her up. And for the same reasons, Paige lets Ryan go on with music, for fear of upstaging him with her beautiful singing voice. Given that everything was going so well, they took the step of buying a home and moving in together in March 2020. Later that year, Ryan mentioned buying a fancy new car, and Paige rightly pointed out that, speaking of lavish purchases, she didn't have an engagement ring yet. And so here we are. The engagement happened on a trip to Inverness in November later that year. They found themselves on Nairn Beach, where amongst the dunes, Ryan popped the question. They enjoyed the remainder of their holiday as a newly engaged couple, and on the return journey home, the excitement didn't stop, as Paige had the entire wedding planned in the 3.5 hour journey. It was that simple. And so we're here today to celebrate their marriage. Now, marriage joins two people who trust in the love they've found. It's a partnership in which each can grow and be true to themselves, while they celebrate the development of the other. Marriage isn't about perfection. It's about loving someone for who they truly are, and the words that are spoken today are less important than how Paige and Ryan behave towards each other when no one else is around. If they can settle their differences with understanding and love, then they can look forward to a future of happiness and contentment. No two relationships are the same. We all bring different qualities that blend together to make them unique. And so I asked Paige and Ryan to share with me what qualities they most love about each other, the reasons that they've chosen to marry each other today. Now, you might like to know that while you're hearing these for the first time, they were passed to me secretly. And so Paige and Ryan are hearing them for the first time as well. So let's begin with what Ryan said about you, Paige. Well, Paige, Ryan says that you are the most beautiful woman in any room, and he loves your smile. He loves how driven and talented you are, achieving anything you set your mind to. And Ryan also loves the generosity and kindness that you show to those around you. Ryan also said that you're always ready to help him finish his chippy, even when you've not been asked to. But most importantly, he loves how happy you make him, and he promises to spend the rest of his life making you as happy as you make him. And now to what Ryan, that's what Paige says about you, Ryan. Well, Ryan, Paige loves how tolerant you are, even if she's being a little bit unreasonable. You're always so positive about everything, always finding something positive to say about everyone and everything. Paige then went on to say that she loves how you support her in everything she does, be it both at the start and the finishing line of her races, or by encouraging her to take on a new challenge when she isn't 100% confident to start it herself. Paige loves that you never see her dinner go to waste. But most importantly, she loves how you make her smile every day and that you are her best friend. And after today, you always will be. And so we've come to the more formal part of the day where Ryan and Paige are going to exchange their rings and their vows and make their legal declarations. So could Ian please bring the rings forward? And Ian, can you please give Ryan's ring to Paige? To love you with all that I am.
To love you with all that I am.
To support, respect, and share with you.
Support, respect, and share with you.
In all of life's decisions.
In all of life's decisions.
Through joy and sadness.
Through joy and sadness.
Triumph and uncertainty.
Triumph and uncertainty.
Laughter and tears.
Laughter and tears.
To have you in my life every day for as long as we live.
Have you in my life every day for as long as we go.
It's definitely.
And Ian, can you now pass Paige's ring to Ryan, please? And you can take your seat now, thank you. So Ryan, with Paige's left hand in yours, please repeat after me. Before our family and friends.
Before our family and friends.
I, Ryan.
I, Ryan.
Accept you, Paige.
Accept you, Paige.
In marriage.
In marriage.
I promise to be your friend and partner.
I promise to be your friend and partner.
And to walk beside you always.
And to walk beside you always.
To love you with all that I am.
To love you. To love you with all that I am.
To support, respect, and share with you.
To support, respect, and share with you.
In all of life's decisions.
In all of life's decisions.
Through joy and sadness.
Through joy and sadness.
Triumph and uncertainty.
Triumph and uncertainty.
Laughter and tears.
Laughter and tears.
To have you in my life every day for as long as we live.
To have you in my life every day as long as we live.
Paige and Ryan, your wedding rings are a token of your love for each other and they stand as a permanent reminder of today. Whenever you look at them, think about each other and remember the happiness that's in this room today for your union. The vows you've spoken are a framework for your life together and combined with your love for each other, they seal the bond between you. May that bond never come undone. Through the joys and sorrows that you may face together. We wish that you walk through life hand in hand, mind to mind, and heart to heart. So Paige and Ryan, now that you've exchanged your marriage vows, declarations and rings in my presence, and in the presence of both your witnesses and guests, It's my pleasure to declare you married and pronounce you husband and wife. Congratulations. Now, wait to say something if you went in too fast. Paige wants me to say, Ryan, you may now kiss your bride. Well, thank you, everyone. Well, they might have sealed it with a kiss, but to make it official, they're now going to sign their marriage schedule, and that's going to be witnessed by Ian and Brooke. Paige and Ryan have chosen some music for you to listen to while that's happening, and I hope it gives you the opportunity to reflect on their marriage in your own individual way. Now, don't wander off just now, because we'll be back in just a couple of minutes to conclude the ceremony.
Heart-wrung tears I'll pledge thee, warring sighs and groans I'll wage thee. Who shall say that fortune grieves him while the star of hope she leaves him? Me, nay cheerful twinkle lights me, dark despair around benights me. I'll ne'er blame my partial fancy, nathan could resist my Nancy. But to see her was to love her, but love her and love forever. We had ne'er loved sae kindly, we had never loved sae blindly. We had never met or never parted. We'd ne'er been broken hearted. Fare thee weel, thou first and fairest. Fare thee weel, thou best and dearest. Thine be ilka joy and treasure, peace, enjoyment, love and pleasure. A fond kiss, and then we sever. A farewell, alas, forever. Deep in heart-wrung tears I'll pledge thee. Warring sighs and groans I'll pledge thee.
As we come to the end of today's ceremony, there's going to be a drinks reception upstairs, and you'll have lots of opportunities to take photos. But Paige and Ryan have asked that I remind you not to post any of them until after they have. You should feel free to post any of yourselves.
Paige and Ryan, I know that everyone here will join me in offering our heartfelt congratulations. We wish you the wonderful contentment and love that a good marriage should bring, and the continuation of the happy life you already have together. Take time to look around you, and then treasure the memory of today and the people who are here sharing it with you. Now, to send our couple into their future with our very best wishes, I would like to ask all of you to join me in a traditional Irish blessing. So if you're able, can you please be upstanding? And repeat after me. Paige and Ryan.
Paige and Ryan.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
May the road rise to meet you.
May the road rise to meet you.
May the wind always be at your back.
May the wind always be at your back.
May the warm rays of the sun fall upon your home.
May the warm rays of the sun fall upon your home.
And may the hand of a friend always be near.
And may the hand of a friend always be near.
May green be the grass you walk on.
May green be the grass you walk on.
May blue be the skies above you.
May blue be the skies above you.
May pure be the joys that surround you.
May pure be the joys that surround you.
And may true be the hearts that love you.
And may true be the hearts that love you.
And so finally, it's my very pleasant task to present to you for the very first time the new Mr. and Mrs. Wells.
Someone who needs me. Speech, however, my lovely wife is making me read this one. I also told not to have a drink before the speech, so let's keep this very short. We're so happy that you could all join us on this very special day to celebrate the marriage of Paige and Ryan. It's nice to see everyone has made a great effort. You've all scrubbed up very well. Most of you. Can I take this opportunity to thank you for travelling some distance and give a special mention to some guests who have gone the extra mile, literally. You have people from Florida, the Netherlands, Dubai, and even some from Pleen. And somewhere called Meagle. We're very glad that each and every one of you could be here today. It definitely wouldn't be the same without you all, but it'd been a hell of a lot cheaper. So on to Paige. Paige is the first daughter of three, so this will be one down, two go. She's funny, intelligent and beautiful, inside and out, just like her old dad. Paige has made us so proud through her life, from being able to tell the time just 4 years old. Her many achievements in dancing, swimming. She's academically gifted, achieving straight A's in every exam she's ever taken. With the exception of her driving test. She's clearly got her intelligence from me, as my E and my English O level I thought was for excellent. Her mum and I couldn't be more proud. when she has pursued a career in dentistry. I'm sure you'll agree the family's teeth never looked better. Paige is still pushing herself today by entering fitness competitions, running 10Ks, which I obviously trained her for. From her curly-haired little darling to the beautiful princess you see here today, we're so happy that she found her Prince Charming and Ryan. Paige and Ryan started dating in 2016. We quickly realised that she was serious and Ryan was the one. Very soon they were looking for their first home and they found their lovely palace in sunny Pullman. They moved into the house in March 2020, just as we went into lockdown. So their party pack sadly didn't host many parties. But I'm sure they'll be ready to make up for lost time now. Ryan came to ask me for Paige's hand in marriage in November 2020. I clearly remember the wise words of advice I gave him. Good luck, Brian. And remember, Ryan, when you're wrong, just admit it. And when you're right, you stop wrong. I'm sure you'll all agree that today has been an emotional day for everyone. I mean everyone, the cake is in tears. A special thanks to Audrey for making me start something about it. Now, on behalf of myself, Jennifer, Brooke and Danny. Dana. We're all glad to welcome Ryan into our family and to welcome Sheena, Gary and Holly into our extended family. I'm going to finish with some wise words. It's only when you reach my age that you realise it means to go home at night to a woman who gives you respect, tenderness and affection. What this means is you went to the wrong house. Just leaves me the privilege of asking you all to stand, raise a glass, wish the newlyweds a long and happy life together to the new Mr. and Mrs. Wells. I better switch this off before.
Lovely words. On days like today, I think it's quite nice to think of the firsts as much as where you are right now. And Eric, I remember the first words that you said to me when I came to visit your house for the first time. You said, "Are you the boy?" I think I can categorically say, today of all days, I am the boy. Eric, as you've shown me around his house, we went down into their basement, into the garage, and into his workshop at the back of the garage, where Eric at length told me about, for those of you who don't know, Eric makes engines, reconditioned these two marvellous engines, the amount of time and effort he spent machining each individual part, the hours that he's ploughed in. And when I was standing there, I thought, this is a man that knows how to keep his head down when he's in trouble, and I should be taking some notes. Jennifer, thank you for everything you've done for us for the wedding. Everything from the original pass through with the flowers, the favours, all the logistics to get everybody here to part of our day. Thank you all so much. And for both, thank you for welcoming me into the family so openly. It really has meant a lot. And also for raising Paige. I know that could not have been easy. I've only had 6 years and it's been a challenge enough. And also to my own mum and dad as well, when we think of first, I mean, we would never have been here if it wasn't for both of you. And today, of all days, I can definitely say we wouldn't be, neither Holly or I would be the people we are without everything you did for us. So please, if you join me in our first toast of the evening to Eric, Jennifer, Sheena and Gary, to the parents. Cheers. Delicious. So, the next thing I want to say here, pay attention, because you're only going to get one chance at this and you better not get it wrong. I would like to say for the first time, on behalf of my wife and I, thank you all so much for being here with us today. It really does mean the world to be surrounded by so many people that we love and care for. Really, you've made this day for us today. Thank you all for coming out. And don't worry, Paige, I'm not going to get into the habit of speaking for you. The next toast I would like to make would be to our beautiful bridesmaids. From the day one, you have been Paige's absolute rock. You have helped her through every stage of the process, from picking dresses to going and organising everything with the hen do's. And I must admit, I never thought I would see my face transfer tattooed on so many bodyguards. Thank you. So the second toast of the night I would please like to give to Brooke, our maid of honour, to Holly, Dana, Claire and Caitlin, to the bridesmaids. Next, I would like to make a toast to the groomsmen. Thank you for everything you've done today, for being here on time, for yourselves, and for helping us make the day run as smoothly as it has today. Thank you for the brilliant stag do as well. Really, really enjoyed it. We will get to the vault one day. I'm pretty sure there's a bus that goes through St. Andrews, and you would know how to take the buses. Thank you as well to both Dana and Ross for your readings today. Really, that was so touching to have you be part of our ceremony. Thank you so much. So please, join me in a toast to the groomsmen. A couple of other thanks we would like to put out as well. Eric has already thanked Audrey for the cake. It looks absolutely wonderful. It tastes even half as good as it looks. We're in for a treat. I'd also like to thank Lucy and the rest of the wedding coordination team here at the Old Course and Tara for everything you've done today to make the day run so smoothly. You've been there with us from day one, helping make this all work. Thank you to everybody working here for all the hospitality. It's been great. And also thank you to the Page Boys and Flower Girls for looking so beautiful and handsome today. Thank you. And that really just leaves me with one person. And the last toast I would like to make is to the most beautiful woman in the room, my wife, Paige. Could you, what does that feel like?
Stop!
Try again, what does that feel like? Who am I? There you go. That was the first joke. Well done for getting that one right. That was the first joke that Paige said to me after we got engaged. We were sitting there with a glass of champagne, which she absolutely tanked, put her hand across the table and said, "Feel this, what does this feel like as wife material?" When we were organising our ceremony, Sheila this morning, our humanist who did the ceremony for us today, sent us through a template with various different choices we could make along the way. And one of the choices that we put out, that we took out very quickly, was to write down three things that you love about the other and one thing that you think would need work. I was not chancing that. For those of you that know Paige, you know that she's very, very strong-willed. She's very headstrong. She knows what she wants and she knows how she's going to get it. It's one of the things I love most about her. But it reminds me of a story from some of our family friends who were buying curtains. And at the time, to cut a long story short, the supplier phoned up the wife saying basically she'd made all these mistakes, everything had gone wrong, and they'd come off the phone very, very angry about this. The husband had phoned back saying, the way that you spoke to my wife was shocking, it was completely unacceptable. And the only thing I could think was, if it was us instead of them, I would be phoning back saying, the way my wife spoke to you was shocking, it was absolutely unacceptable. Now, I could go on and talk about many other stories here, like the time that Paige drooled so much she gave herself conjunctivitis. You can get that one out of me later on. But thinking of, to bring this back to a close, like thinking of kind of where we started and where we are just now, we met 6 years ago, we've had such a great time from here on out, and I can't wait to see where we go in the future. So please, would you join me in the last toast of the evening to my beautiful wife, to Paige. And I'll now pass on to Ian for his speech. Anything he says that's bad is a compulsive liar. Anything he says that's nice is completely true. Ian, over to you.
Hi everyone, can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
I was hoping for a Britney mic, but this is... as Ryan mentioned, my name's Ian. And I have the absolute honour and privilege of being Ryan's best man today. So before the food comes out, I'll just take a couple of moments to tell you all a little bit about Ryan. And if anyone's got a sweet day on the length of this speech, now's the time to slip me a tenner. Ryan and I, we first met at university, but we didn't really hang out much. I didn't like him, not kidding. In different friendship groups, but after uni, we went to join the same company in Glasgow. We've got some colleagues coming back as well from that time. They all waved, I didn't expect it. It was while we were working there that we grew really close over a shared love of drinking too much coffee during the day, drinking too much Tennent's at night, and generally avoiding doing any work. I vividly recall a day at work when Ryan posted a picture on Facebook of some questionable latte art. And within a couple of minutes, his wonderful mum, Sheena, posted a comment underneath asking, "Do you ever do any work?" It's a bit of a late reply, Sheena, sorry, but absolutely not. It was when Ryan and I were working in that company that he first met Paige. It was one wintry morning. Ryan, we sat across from each other in the office. Ryan sort of peered over his monitor, a bit like a mongoose, with a sly look in his eye. Fortunately, because of the height of his hair at the time, had a good like 5 second warning. And it was then that Ryan told me that he'd organised a date. A date. I politely informed Ryan that I just saw him as a friend. I didn't really want to blur those lines. That was when Ryan told me about Paige. He told me that he'd known Paige for ages since they were really young, and they kind of reconnected online, and he was really excited. He was so giddy about going out for a drink. I looked through Ryan and I's WhatsApp chat to try and find a nice quote from around that time, December 2016. And I found one. And I wanted to share it tonight so that Paige could take away these four beautiful words from Ryan at that time. Ryan said after the date, "She's clever and fit." Jokes aside though, that was the start of something obviously incredibly beautiful, and to Paige I owe a thanks, because since then I've just never seen Ryan happier. For those who maybe don't know Ryan as well as I do, I'm jealous, but also I've compiled a list of things that Ryan absolutely loves, just three things that I want to call out. The first thing is Ryan loves a stage performance. Either going to watch one or being in one. Ryan has performed as Jean Valjean in Les Mis. Hopefully I've said that right, I don't know.
It's a triumph.
apparently he smashed it. He also played the toy maker in Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. The casting director said he was too creepy for the channel catch. And he played everyone's favourite cat that wears white spats, Bustopher Jones in Cats, who, much like Ryan, absolutely loves a curry. Secondly, Ryan loves to build things. He loves to build things. In fact, they built the app that we can use today called Big Album to take photos of each other. Ryan and I have a sort of friendly competitiveness, so it absolutely pains me to say that the app's actually really good. So I'll report that. Building things, software, but also Lego and Disney. So I've got a small token of that for Paige in the form of a rose for Ryan's very own bell. And of course, it would be absolutely criminal for me not to mention this last one on the list. It's the reason why Ryan is obviously here with us today. His incredible, beautiful Jaguar F-Type. Two-liter four-cylinder engine. It's a work of art, and for that I've also brought Ryan a small token of that to you. Yeah. actually sent me two of those if there was an error, so I've got one in my gaff as well. It's a nice reminder for me to actually learn how to drive. But to round up, and we're all getting pretty hungry and want some food, I've just got a simple message to give to Ryan and Paige. I better not cry. Paige, it's rare to find someone as loving and caring and kind as Ryan. And so, Ryan, for you to find someone as loving and caring and kind, just as loving and caring and kind as you and Paige, is really something special. In the most beautiful way, you both deserve each other, and you both deserve a lifetime of love, care and support from one another. And to everyone else, I would just ask that you join me in raising a toast to the newlyweds, Ryan and Paige.
Only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you? Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for
Page field now. you once again, please put your hands together for the great looking Mr. and Mrs. Wells. Just dive right in, follow my lead. I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. One never knew you were that someone waiting for me. We were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing why. Just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, your hope is mine. Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms. Listening to our favorite song, when you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, you heard it, darling, you look perfect tonight. Ladies and gents, any of the wedding party, will you join them on the dance floor?
Yeah. Wanna see you shake your booty on the dance floor? Throw some shades, bust some moves, cut some run, get down. Come on! When you look wide and bleach, perhaps there's a lovely way you'll see later. Come on, everybody! It's a celebration.